New this morning, the disappearance of Northport woman Gabby Petito shined a spotlight on missing persons cases. But it's not new to forensic anthropologists at USF who have worked tirelessly for years to identify the lost. Tragically, we now know Gabby was found dead, but there are countless other cases where advancements in science and technology will give hope to so many other families. ABC Action News reporter Michael Paluska has that story.
But the really exciting sort of newest way in which we're getting identifications, and I think there's the most potential, is the genealogical DNA testing.
Dr. Erin Kimmerly is a forensic anthropologist at USF. She analyzes evidence to identify people from some of the oldest cases in Florida and across the country, using modern technology to rewrite the old school archaic approach from the past.
We brought over 140 cases up to current standards. That basically means going back as if it was just a case starting today. We do everything over. And so ideally, in a perfect world, that would be done on every case. And probably about 24 of those have been resolved.
Going back and looking at those old cases takes time and funding. Forensic anthropologists can use skeletal biology to create facial reconstructions of what someone would look like with striking results. But Kimmerly says the future is in DNA genealogical tests.
And then having a genealogist put together that family tree. And then you start to work down and work backwards by finding extended family and figuring out who this person is. But it works.
Kimmerly says with each passing year, it can get harder and harder to identify someone. And sadly, more and more people go missing or are murdered every year. The old cases seemingly vanish just like the dead.
And what happens is they tend to fall to the bottom of the queue. So new homicides come in, new missing person cases come in, and those John and Jane Does just tend to fall to the bottom of the line.
In Tampa, Michael Paluska, ABC Action News.